predatory lesbians.
And it wasn't Pompeii, it was Pompeii.
He's like, you see all these kids doing shit so fast? What are they doing?
Playing with the dubstep knob.
Okay. Potential problems broadcast. How are you guys?
You're listening to the Potential Problems.
Put it in your ass, loser.
Potential Problems Podcast.
Hey, how y'all doing?
He's working on the levels. Hey,
they can hear us now.
Okay, great. How much? So they know it's Potential Problems Podcast, right? Yeah. And they know it's John Cuellar, right? Well, they do now. Cool. Okay. Cool. And then also with us today, let's just go ahead and jump right in. Alan Clark is not here.
He was
on his way, I think, to Colorado, and we haven't heard from him. So either he was in a major accident or he got there safely, and he doesn't care about us. Either way, we wish him the best. I'm joined today by Greg Jomick. Hey,
hi.
Friend of the show.
What's up?
Friend of the family. Greg Jomick, how's it going, buddy?
Oh, it's great. I've been cleaning my old house all day, and my hands are all fucked up and...
Your hands rougher than Maverick McWilliams?
They look almost as fucked up as his hands always do.
What are you cleaning? What kind of cleaning are you doing? Scrubbing
just
the toilets?
Scrubbing every little nook and cranny in that old house. And there's a lot of, it collects a lot of dirt is what I've come to learn today.
But what about the house?
Hey.
So how many hours were you cleaning for?
I don't know, like four? That's four more hours than I've cleaned in a while, so that was a lot.
Yeah.
Fucking
well, good for you. Good on you, sir. You don't smoke weed. That's why you probably did some cleaning today.
Yeah.
I was supposed to do some cleaning, and I smoked weed instead and fell asleep.
Oh.
So it was a good morning, too.
It's a good payoff.
Yeah. Hey, Greg, we're joined today by Melissa Esslinger.
Yeah.
Hey there.
What's
and
up?
And your friend from L.A.,
yeah.
Jonathan J., right?
Yeah, just the letter J.
The letter Green. J, gotcha.
I mean, it's Jonathan. We don't need all that Jonathan part of it all. It's just J. Jay Green.
You're in Albuquerque for a few days, right?
Yes, I am, and I'm enjoying it
awesome.
Very much so.
Cool. Awesome. I think we have someone knocking at the door. If you want to let John in, we'll let him chill here, though, and we'll just bring him in a little bit. We have a stacked lineup here.
Oh,
maybe that's
off.
Not him. Oh, yeah.
No.
Give him a little bit of time.
Get scared.
You can switch me off.
In a little bit. Anyway, Melissa, how are you doing today?
Good.
Cool.
Good.
Cool. How do you know Jay?
We
How'd
met.
You guys meet?
We met at Marty's.
Marty's is a great open mic spot in Los Angeles.
Yeah.
7 days a week, stand-up. 7 hours a day.
Yeah.
So anytime, you can just go up in there and work on material. And that's it's like a clubhouse for comedians in L.A.
Oh, cool.
And,
it's a pretty chill spot.
Yeah, we ran into each other there and been buddies ever since.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, cool. So you guys have known each other how long?
3 years?
Maybe 3 years. I'm
2 or 3 years, somewhere in there.
Probably three.
Yeah.
Definitely three. But maybe even more than that, mm-hmm. but at least 3 years, I think. So
very cool.
Just the homie. The homie.
So you done a couple of gigs in Albuquerque yet, or do you have your first one tonight?
No, we went to Maria Bamford.
How was that?
Show.
How was Bamford?
It was good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Opening act was good. Maria was good.
Who was her opener? Do you guys know him?
Jackie.
I can't remember her last name.
Cation. I know
yeah.
Jackie Cation because I was like vacation. Yeah.
Oh, Jackie Cation's hilarious.
Yeah.
Yeah,
she was.
She ripped
it. She murdered.
Very cool.
Yeah.
So, and Maria, what was her set like? What is she?
Her set was good. It looks like she's working on material though, but her set was very good.
Yeah,
I mean, still worth the money, you know. It's
not yeah. Did you guys see her recent special?
I haven't
the most
yet,
recent.
No.
I was just wondering how much of that stuff she used. Mm-hmm. like in this, because that was like what, I think a year and a half ago.
Yeah.
Or was that?
I saw like half of it. I didn't recognize anything.
I highly doubt that she was working on. I didn't see the special, but I'm sure if I watched the special, it's just gonna be totally different than what I saw last night.
She turned me down in a speed dating effect.
What? We'll have to get to that story, John Smilowitz. Off camera is John Smilowitz. He'll be joining us a little bit later. Do you really have Emmys?
Yeah.
Jesus Christ.
What?
I'm going to have to ask you about that. Yeah. Okay. So
we can switch.
Yeah, we'll do that in a little bit. You guys have a show. You're doing a show tonight, right, Greg?
Yeah. So tonight is the first of the new version of the show that I'm running. It's going to be called Greg's Comedy Friendship. Because they're not happening in a basement anymore.
Yeah, who's responsible for closing this basement? I heard it was a fire hazard. Someone passed out.
A man did pass out at that show at a show about a month ago, and you know it was his fault, and he knows it. So, you know, he was like severely dehydrated, and he had like worked on his yard all day, gotten a bike wreck earlier. And then instead of eating food or drinking water, he just showed up and started drinking beer in the basement in May in Albuquerque. So
that's not right.
Yeah, poor guy. He felt extremely bad and has apologized profusely. So it's gross how much he's apologized.
Well, there's no reason to apologize for that. I mean, I think we've all had that moment.
It's fine. I'm fine with it. But like, it did freak people out. It like walked half the room right in the middle of Kendra's set, and that was really.
Are you sure that wasn't her set? No, I'm just kidding. She's hilarious. She'd be the first one to laugh because she's pretty awesome. Yeah, that was an interesting night. It's always we talked about. You told a story previously about how some guy had a seizure in the middle of
a set that I did right after doing this podcast one time.
Oh, really?
This is sounding very exciting for me tonight, I gotta tell you.
Oh, no, this was not at one of my shows. This was at a show I did.
Well, it's still your karma.
Yeah, I got people freezing up and falling down seems to be a reoccurring theme. There's something about just how high quality my jokes are that makes people's brains stop.
Yeah, I can understand. I can.
It's just a power that I don't know how to wield yet.
You gotta deal with it.
Cameron, what are you on Twitter? Sorry about that.
Oh boy, what kind of show is
Voice
this?
Voice Box Studios. Just Voice Box, I think.
Okay, cool. Anyway, yeah. So I just had to. I'm trying
stop
to fucking
what's your
do
Twitter?
This. Well, I like post other this link. Usually we have an extra person to do this, but we don't. Because Alan died in a highway accident, as you may have heard.
His diaper got so full that he slipped out of the baby booster seat that he sits in when he drives.
Yeah, he's a small man.
And then, like, all the turds shot up on the windshield. And then so his wonderful wife tried to take control of the steering wheel, couldn't see anything because there was little baby poo everywhere.
Baby poo.
That shot out of his little diaper. That's what I heard on the news.
We're getting differing accounts, I would say. But
yeah,
that's,
but
they're
I
all...
think I'm pretty sure what I just said was real.
There's a common thread. Melissa, are you doing anything coming up? You had a I helped you move. That's what we did together. It was like we worked.
That's why I got. I was like, I'm gonna get him some good stuff.
Oh, why? Thank you. Like, yeah, you certainly did. You went all out.
Bud Light. I was like,
hey, I'm brown. What else do I have? Some roofing this weekend. I'm just trying to rehydrate. That's all. Did you? So how's your new place working out?
I like it. Yeah. I'm liking it.
Have you had any roaches crawling on your back? That happened.
All the roaches that I've seen inside have been dead so far. So that's cool. I think my cat takes care of it.
Do you ever have any guilt about killing ants or spiders? Or are you pretty cool with that?
Usually only if I'm stoned. I guess I'm only humane if I'm. I don't know. No.
No. Right. How do you?
A
kill
little
them?
Bit. Well, I don't like to kill spiders. I guess I'd try to just get them out. I don't like spiders, though. I'll kill it.
Are you one to, like, spray it down with, like, rage?
I'll spray it with, like, anything that I have. So it might be Lysol or... I feel like it does the same thing.
Sometimes. Febreze doesn't do anything to
it. Yeah, Febreze just smells. Yeah, but
it
just
makes a good smelling
soap.
Nice smelling roach, yeah. let's see here. So do you guys follow wrestling at all? You a fan of the wrestling at all?
Wrestling.
Any wrestling?
Not in today's age, but back in the day.
Back in the day. So maybe you know about this. Recently, we had the 20th anniversary of the Hell in the Cell cage. You guys know anything about the Hell in the Cell cage?
The
between the Undertaker and Mankind?
yeah.
Now, this is a classic wrestling match, which none of you are going to be interested in, obviously, because you don't have an attachment to it. But it was kind of like a 20-year anniversary of this thing where the very first thing they did within the first, I'd say the first 5 minutes, it's in the thread towards, there we go. The very first thing they did was Undertaker basically throws Mankind through the cage. Now, I did see this. Yeah, I heard this was like a mistake. Like the cage wasn't supposed to open up on him. So let's see here. So this is like pretty quick. They climb right up to the top of the cage.
Really bad climbing technique.
Wouldn't it be cool if like one of them fell off of it? And that's not going to happen. And then all of a sudden, there goes Mick.
Daniel Bryan.
Oh.
It was almost like in slow motion.
Hey.
You know, and he starts to kind of go over you like no.
Kofi Kingston.
He's gonna catch himself. Oh my God. He's
falling. Oh no.
He's falling.
So then he threw him, yeah, onto the announcer's table.
JR is the best.
He's a little bit
JR fucking
a little dramatic.
You ever have his barbecue sauce?
Oh my God. No, does it make
Wait,
your
so nobody actually knows.
No, just half your
face.
And
I don't know how he's still alive to this day.
What was that, Melissa?
I was just, nobody knows in that moment actually if he is okay.
Well, you know what?
Do they?
Falling from that height, it's completely possible. It's completely possible to like sever a major artery.
Yeah.
You can have a right. Tell us, Dr. Greg.
Well, he's a big boy. He's got a lot of cushion to keep Ooh. All of those things from happening.
You heard it from Greg. The guy could have died instantly. And so anyway, it was just. But that's not the worst of it. So to start the match, they throw each other off the cage. But then it gets progressively more violent. If you look, despondent Vince McMahon is very despondent. Is the look I'd see on his face. So then, this is just the beginning of the match. They get these paramedics come out and they get him up, and they get him on a stretcher. But he says, "No, I'm not going." And he gets up. He gets
I'm
off the
done.
Stretcher. And he goes back into the match, and it gets a lot more brutal from there.
And they had Sergeant Slaughter out there acting serious.
Yeah, they tried to get Corporal Kirshner, but I don't know.
What Corporal Kirshner.
And then so look, here he's coming back to the ring after taking two huge bumps, one off the top of the cage onto the table, and then one through the cage here.
He's insane.
What's that?
He's going to finish this match, though. That's
oh, he had to. That's what you have to do, Smilowitz. So let's see here. Can you go forward a little bit? I want to show the tack part. Mark Henry, strongest man.
Is he moving?
Okay, so that was after I think he threw it. I think he skipped the tack part. Let's see here. They dump some tacks on the floor, and then he gets pretty much body slammed onto it.
Anybody realized that would not be the case?
Okay.
Oh!
Yeah, that's where he broke through. Now, that's a major bump. That cage was not supposed to open like that. Have you guys have ever...
That's it, he's dead.
You gotta be kidding.
Just still watching.
I think even Undertaker was bobbed. Like, what?
Mm-hmm.
Oh!
It wasn't much of a choke slam. It was more like a choke push.
Kind of contorted. Yeah. The other fall didn't kill him. This one's definitely gonna kill him.
Wow. Yeah.
Stop the damn match! Oh my God!
All right, so go towards the end here. Go skip to the end here. Let's see here. Yeah, the tax. Here we go. Oh, that's the last one.
Wait, they kept going more?
Oh yeah. Look. So go back a little bit, Kim, because I want to see the tax. That's the best part.
A little bit more.
Boom!
Ay, Dios mío.
Choke slam onto the tax.
I just got like really invested for a second.
Yeah, like, I wonder what's going to happen.
Shit. From head to toe with silver.
So the 20th anniversary of, I mean, Mick Foley, he just took some abuse. This is one of the legendary matches in WWE history. And if you're not a wrestling fan, even if you just sit down and you watch this, you'll be pretty amazed at just the level of punishment. I mean, this is all show.
Right.
This is all for show. So it's an amazing match. Check it out if you get a chance.
Wrestling. I like that they didn't even let him win that match. Like they were like, okay, we're gonna claim you dead twice, and then pierce your body with thumbtacks, and then you're gonna just lose. And the guy that just brutally beats the shit out of you gets to walk away fine.
Yep, just take all the bumps and get none of the glory, as
they
say.
How do they make those decisions?
On who wins, or usually it's kind of like they have a. I think they kind of have a.
I think the ref determines who's the best kisser before the match starts.
That's, I knew it.
And then they kind of figure it out from there.
Your short answer, I'd say writers, pretty much. Writers.
Yeah, the writers.
And there's a lot of complaining now in wrestling. That the writers are in charge more than ever and the wrestlers don't get to.
So it's like an SNL thing almost.
Yeah, a little bit, yeah. It makes you think. did you guys hear about Peppermint or a Peppermint Patty?
Peppermint Patty?
Yeah, oh, you guys heard about Peppermint Patty.
I saw the video. The person before her that called.
Barbecue Betty.
I saw her.
So we.
I have no idea what you're saying.
Okay, well,
Greg, you're about to get blown away, bro.
No, so, so last Saturday, I believe this was in San Francisco, right?
Mm-hmm.
A young lady, a young child, about 8 years old, was selling bottles of water.
Ah.
Well, this lady decided that it was an issue, so she said she was going to call the cops. Mm-hmm. The 8-year old girl. Her mom or auntie or somebody started filming this lady calling the cops.
Right.
And it became this big national thing. Like, Twitter loves villains. Yeah. Either to make them more popular or, you know, just to hate on them. Either one. Well, they love them. So this lady went viral. They started calling her Permit Patty. And it was a play on Barbecue Becky, who was this lady that... in similar fashion of just being an asshole, called the cops on this family that was having a barbecue in the park, like any of us might, you know? And she basically was trying to get him in trouble. So here's Permit Patty. And you haven't seen this, Greg?
No, now I know what you're talking about. Okay. I just didn't know they had fun nicknames.
But they have great.
Have you seen the video?
Have you seen the video?
I haven't seen the video. I haven't seen this one.
I've seen the video. I feel sorry for her. I just want to say this
a little bit, right?
And I'm speaking as a young daughter who sells water. basically, I can relate to the little girl buying selling the water, and I still feel sorry for Permit Patty. She was just being a jerk,
but does she really need her life ruined over it, right? Okay, so go ahead and play it, Cam.
This woman don't want to let a little girl sell some water. She calling the police on an 8-year-old little girl.
She should have done the elevator move and slowly lowered the
or what if she did the stairs?
On my property.
It's not your property.
This woman don't want to let a little girl sell some water.
Okay, so... basically, yeah, she called the cops, and then she went viral. Well, it turns out that Permit Patty, I keep wanting to say peppermint.
Yes.
But Permit Patty works for a cannabis company. Now, we went to the 420 Fest, and we met probably some vendors that do a very similar thing. We had one on our show, Greg.
Oh, yeah, I was there.
She made CBD treats for dogs and cats with anxiety. Yeah. Pretty cool shit that they're doing now for anxiety for pets. Well, this lady kind of ran the same type of business, founded this business, and she made this stupid decision and went viral. She has now been booted from the company.
Right.
The company has lost a major contract with a couple of suppliers because, you know, Twitter, you know, shamed them kind of. And this lady is basically, I mean, this will die down. That still is just
their
so
face.
Great. Do you have the side-by-side of Permit Patty
and Barbecue
Becky? Because I know they have a bunch. But they look, it's so crazy because they look so similar. Yeah,
they fit a description.
Now, Jay, you were saying you feel kind of bad for
her. So I feel kind of bad for her, first of all, because she's selling weed for dogs. I can't, already I'm like, oh, that's wrong.
You're in her corner.
I love dogs. I love weed. This is wrong. And the other part about it is when she hid from the video, it almost felt to me like she started to realize that she might be wrong in doing what she was doing. But she had already committed, and
which
is different if you ask me than Barbecue Becky, because Barbecue Becky seems like she's on a mission.
Oh yeah,
like she was sent from the future to call the cops on people barbecuing. But Permit Patty looks like, oh, I like cold. I like people to fall in the cold. Mm. I got a permit to sell this weed to these dogs. She should have a permit to sell this water to these people. But
now her life's completely changed. But. You know, the good thing about this whole news cycle is, yeah, she's going to take a heavy hit now, but I think in about 6 months, people will probably forget her until the next one
well,
comes
she'll be
up.
Like a, and then she'll be like a judge on America's Got Talent.
So well, that, yeah, I'm sure there'll be a redemption show for these people. So
you think so?
I don't know about Ben.
Oh, yeah, social redemption. Mm-hmm.
Well, they'll be, like, collected on, like, a racial version of Scared Straight. It's like they have to like hang out and be like scolded. Like they have like a bunch of white people be like, "Why are you being such a piece of shit?" And then a bunch of people of color being like, "Hey, chill out."
That's pretty much how it would go too. Like,
yeah.
Hosted
by Roseanne Barr.
So let's see. Yeah. So I mean, we wish Permit Patty. I guess the best you could say. We hope things turn around for her. But she definitely, I think, has learned her lesson about intervening in situations that really don't require any intervention. You know, if she would have walked away at that point when that lady started following her, mm-hmm. if she just would have stopped calling and walked away, mm-hmm. do you think she would have been cool? Do you think she would have been saved?
Or at least said something like, you know what, that was weird. Why, I don't know what I was doing.
Yeah. Mm.
Like, I just want to, I got some weed and I got to sell this dog around the corner. And, like, I'm fucking up my sales over here. I got to stop.
Yeah.
But she didn't do that.
If I may add, there is, if required viewing, there's a hashtag shut it down.
Mm-hmm.
And basically it's Twitter's response to Permit Patty. Basically, a lot of black people are going to buy lemonade from kids just selling lemonade,
yeah.
and they ask, you have a permit? And if they don't, they tell them to shut it down. Shut it down. Check it out. It's pretty funny. If you see, it's a lot of little ones that's out there, so memes and whatnot.
Now I miss Vine. I bet there would have been
Vine would have been killing this game right now.
We'll have to check that out. Ed, you got time to search for that, Cam? You doing okay over there?
Shut it down thing.
Yeah, the shut it down thing.
Yeah, we have hashtag shut it down on our Twitter or on our stream right now.
See. Oh,
that's beautiful. Shut it down.
Shut it down.
You guys got a permit? Do you have a permit?
Now, can you explain to our audience what Black Twitter is? A lot of people don't know
Black
about
Twitter,
this.
First of all, I'm just now figuring out what Black Twitter is. I thought it was a place you go to or something along those lines where you type in Black Twitter, but you just type Twitter. Yeah. And apparently, like, the people who, you know, tweet a lot that represent black issues and talk about just funny stuff that black people talk about are known as Black Twitter. You basically, the hashtags and the...
They're more specific to subjects.
Yeah, the subjects.
All the Arthur memes come from.
The Arthur memes and, yeah, a lot of the cool stuff on Twitter.
Yeah, some of the best stuff.
Kind of like
Twitter
real life. But on Twitter, so it's just the.
Is this.
No, these. That's definitely
all of these
not
are
shit
real.
This looks like this is all protest stuff.
Yeah. So
we don't need to revisit.
Yeah, yeah. It looks like
I just
Permit Patty is over.
Oh, yeah, but this is. So this is all the brutality stuff, huh?
Yeah. Oh, it looks like now they're talking about shutting down. Yeah, so yeah, I think they've moved past.
Well, yeah, that was last week already.
Yeah, that was last week, so it's not a joke anymore to do the permit thing. But
let's see here. So, hey, Greg, you're a medical type. Have you ever heard of vaginismus?
Yeah.
Am I saying that right?
Yeah.
Okay, I want to know if this is a real thing. Have you guys ever heard of vaginismus?
Explain.
Sounds like a holiday for vaginas.
Okay, it's something to do with it, yeah. So my understanding of vaginismus, as represented in a story I read, is basically that the muscles are too tight, I guess, and they're basically impenetrable.
Wow.
These women can't have sex. It hurts very much to put a tampon in. I was reading this documentary. This filmmaker made a documentary, and she chronicled her difficulty with this. And so I wanted to ask you, Greg, have you ever run into this issue before? Is this a thing? Do you think she's making it up?
No, I mean, it's definitely a real thing. I've never seen, I had a gynecology rotation, and I saw a lot of interesting
cooters.
Women's vaginas. not a lot of interesting men's vaginas, but women's vaginas were pretty interesting because I worked like in a urogynecology unit for 2 weeks and we saw a lot of prolapsed organs.
Nice.
And I was like, when I first like heard about like what described what it was, I was like, wow, this is going to be completely difficult to see. And then I saw it, and I was like, you know, prolapsed uterus is not nearly as gross as I thought it would be, but maybe it's because I'm so desensitized by medical pathology at this point in my life that I'm just like, yeah, no, it just looks like a pink softball rolling out of you. Okay.
What's the difference between a rosebud and a prolapse, technically speaking?
Rosebud, there was a cool movie made with that name.
Citizen Kane, sure,
Citizen
yes.
Citizen Kane, yeah, that's right. I fucked that up. No movie about with the name prolapse or as it being a very important
But have you part seen rosebudding videos?
No.
You've never seen it? Okay, that's all right.
No, is that a part of X videos I haven't gotten into yet?
Yeah, it's a thing that comes across your search every once in a while. And, yeah. So,
you just check the front page, and sometimes some wild shit gets on that.
Yeah, Smiley Woods is going to check it out. Maybe you can give us a report here in a second. No, but right. Let me look at this story here. Her name is Shelby Haddon, 25-year-old. She made a documentary about her condition, and it's a 10-minute film called Tightly Wound.
That is pretty on the nose right there.
In it, she documents her countless trips to the doctors and string of failed relationships. I want to have sex. I want to do it so badly, she says. I obsess over sex by constantly reading about it in memoirs, magazine articles, and novels.
Memoirs?
Yeah, I was like, what memoirs have a lot of sex in them? I don't know, the J. Edgar Hoover memoirs were a little bit interesting. So, yeah.
Barbara Bush memoirs.
And
there's like half of that book is just about her boning down.
Is that it? Yeah. I can't believe it.
She was very sex positive, but closeted about it for a while.
Let's see here. I watch TV shows and movies to gobble it all up and learn as much as I can. I fantasize about sex.
Now I feel like this is a bit.
You think she's like being a little bit too? No, I really want to. Let's see here. Well, some men can't get it up. I can't get it in. No, that's a pretty good quote. What do you
think?
That
is a good quote.
Let's see. I knew something was wrong when I was 14 and I started my period. When I tried using a tampon for the first time, I felt like I was forcing it into a hole that wasn't there, causing excruciating, stabbing pain. Yeah. Sorry. God, just wanted to emphasize
suck.
That. Yeah, no shit, huh?
I love sex. That would suck.
Let's see here. Some doctors refused, Greg Jomick, to even examine me because I wasn't sexually active. I was given a lot of bad advice and little empathy. Eventually, she found a pelvic floor physical therapy. Jeez, is that what Dr. Nasser used to do? Is that what? I don't know. That sounds like it's the same thing.
It's like
used for funnels.
What is the name? What is the name when you like? You just Kegels? Dance around with ribbons and stuff?
Oh, the ribbon dancing thing?
Yeah. yeah, the ribbon.
That's the technical name for it. Yeah.
Isn't it called like floor or something? What am I?
Yeah, rhythmic.
Rhythmic? No, there's like a floor. There's a exercise. Maybe a. I don't know.
I don't know either. Those like streamers.
Damn it, John.
look.
Are there three Johns here right now, technically?
Technically.
There are, yeah. That's crazy.
It happens that way.
So I'm interested in seeing this film. This is basically she says her vagina is impenetrable, and if I had sleeves to roll up now, I would be doing that.
But, up my...
Yeah, it's like hey, a wet noodle can penetrate anything most of the time. So give me my
watch
shot.
The trailer.
give me a chance.
Is there the trailer? Let's see. Is there a trailer? This might be the whole film.
Oh,
starts well.
Yeah,
cool.
What's wrong?
So,
I like the way the doctors move.
Oh, fuck.
Vaginismus is a pelvic floor condition where the muscles in my vagina involuntarily contract, making me too tight to penetrate. It's why I'm in my mid-20s and have never had a boyfriend, fallen in love, or had sex.
Okay, I'm still not hearing anything about the anal muscles. Seems like those are good to go.
Well, it's all part of the... Well, part of it A lot of it's part of the public.
So you're saying if you can't go in the front door, you can't go in the ass either. Is that what you're trying to say, technically speaking?
No, no, not specifically, but it depends on what's all
involved. It could be. It could be part of
it. She could just get some Botox shots, man. Fucking.
Yeah. Would that do it?
Yeah, for sure.
Botox in the giner?
But just in the muscle.
It's contracting, right?
Yeah, you just have to relax.
Don't contract.
Yeah.
Well, that's cool.
Yeah.
Well, maybe
she could just take she could take a can of like spoiled peas, just rub around there, get that botulism in there. Oh my God. It's the same chemical, just in a substantially higher dose when it's
look at
actually
John's face
produced from
when
the
you said that.
Is this because Botox comes from the botulinum organism? Botulinum toxin is made by bacteria. So when people get botulism, the same thing that like kills you because you can't breathe is the same chemical they use in Botox. So you just DIY Botox. Which is like extremely bad because the Botox injections you get is like such a small concentration compared to what you would get from the bacteria. So it's a terribly bad idea and extremely gross. But
it sounds pretty funny.
Yeah.
We can't get it past that part.
Oh, shit. I think I'm gonna buy this film when it comes out. Is it coming to Netflix or something like that?
Yeah,
10-minute vaginal film.
It's just a 10-minute film, though, right?
Yeah,
I think YouTube will have it.
Do they have shorts on Netflix? Do you know?
They used to. I don't know if they do anymore.
Oh, you wouldn't think so, sir.
No, I said I would be surprised if they didn't.
Yeah. Let's see here. So, do you guys want to do the news stories or videos? News stories or videos.
I've been a big fan of these videos so far.
We'll give, Melissa, do you want to move over? Okay. So we'll bring in John here.
John Smoltz.
Oh, man, he has loose candy in his pockets.
He does.
He's
out cruising for children.
I felt that vibe from you.
5-minute rule. 5-minute rule.
Don't worry, those are Skittles. They make
it
through.
Yeah, let's talk to John a little bit about his Emmys.
Where's the?
I wanted to talk about the rosebud thing.
Well, we will get to the rosebud thing, but we're all fascinated. So you brought one of your Emmys to the open mic.
Yeah, that's
on Tuesday.
Wait, a real Emmy?
Yeah.
He has a real live Emmy, living and breathing, and we're gonna delve into that.
It doesn't
actually
breathe.
It doesn't.
It lives.
You let it die?
It died.
Oh.
First of all,
this is why you're having trouble out there. You got to let it dance and live and breathe.
I did. I actually tried putting it on like a necklace, one of those Run DMC gold chain necklaces.
Oh, cool.
How did that go?
I hit me in the nads the first day. So
it didn't go well.
Shouldn't have measured the chain.
Running too low.
Yeah. It was like a small target. I'm like, how could I hurt
you? Can't
such...
use like, if you use real gold, it just gets soft when it's around your neck and then it just stretches down. You shoot it.
Never had a problem
you
with that.
You should have known that.
John Smilowitz, that's the guest that we're bringing in here. He's how long have you been doing comedy for?
7 years.
And how long have you been in New Mexico for?
3 months.
Okay, 3 months.
Well, I left for a month, came back.
Oh, yeah.
I'm only allowed to leave Las Vegas for a month or two at a time.
Okay, are you based in Las Vegas, or are you honestly, truly residing in New Mexico? I need to know for voting purposes.
I'm technically still based in Vegas.
Oh, okay, cool. Oh,
that's cool.
Until my probationary officer finds out.
Gotcha, and then you'll be dragged screaming and kicking back to Vegas. But until then, you're here with us.
Nice.
How did you get an Emmy? What do you have an Emmy for? Just I know you seem like you play it up because you like to kind of be funny guy, but you don't really go around saying, "Hey, I have an Emmy, asshole." But I'm asking you now, how did you get
it? I would never say I have an Emmy, asshole. I would say I have two Emmys, asshole.
How did you get them?
I used to work on this show called The Bold and the Beautiful.
Cool. No. That is cool. Yeah. So you edited all the hardcore sex scenes out, right?
We edited the G-rated sex scenes.
Oh, okay.
And they had to be very G-rated. Like, as soon as a person wrapped their leg around another person's leg, and they had to be fully dressed for these sex scenes.
Yeah.
You do a star wipe, something cool like
sometimes.
That.
Sometimes. But the people would be like, oh, that leg is wrapped around, and we'd watch. About five people would come into the room. We'd be like, it's wrapped around. No, it's not. And basically, as they'd say, frame fuck it until the leg was not technically wrapped around the other leg.
Because that's
then we'd
when.
Be like, that's where sex ends.
So that's like when the standards and practices guidelines kind of kick in and you really have to pay close attention to those specific details, right?
Yeah. As soon as we saw like a hip. Yeah, there we go. As soon as we saw like a hip thrust.
Oh.
That's where you cut up to the next shot.
Yeah.
And people would come into the room and be like, that's not a hip thrust. frame forward. It's that's like, not a hip. That's a hip thrust. Cut.
How long did you work on that show for?
7 years.
Whoa, cool. Was wow. it? Did you like that job?
They paid me to watch hits.
And they
paid. I'm not a fan of soap operas. It was interesting, but.
But it's got to be good pay. It's television.
Oh,
work,
it was
right?
great pay. It was the network, easiest though. Job I ever had for the highest amount, and probably the biggest regret I had was leaving that job.
Yeah. But, why did you leave it?
I'm a nighttime guy, and I couldn't stand working.
Serial killer, huh? Yeah,
yeah,
go ahead.
Exactly. Serial killer, rapist. I mean, the line is
nighttime guy is like the
eater. Serial eater.
The serial version of Lady of the Night.
Yeah.
Nighttime guy. The male
version. Yeah, because like you got this guy's trying to be cool, so it's like I'm not a man of the night. I'm a nighttime guy.
I'm a lady of the nighttime guy.
So you did that for 7 years. You decided. Decided you wanted to do something else, and then what did you move on to after that?
Looking for work.
Okay, yeah, that's usually how it goes.
With two Emmys, though.
That's
it doesn't mean anything.
You
in
put
business.
That on your resume. Can't you put that on your resume?
Put it on
and people
resume.
Will be impressed.
Just walk into their office and drop them on the desk.
Yeah,
hire
smack them in the face at the end of the interview.
No, not how it works.
It's funny. I still apply for jobs. I put how many years I've worked as an editor. I just posted this on Facebook. I was so pissed.
Yeah, I saw this.
Because, you know, I've worked for like 25 years. I got two Emmys.
A beer, by the way?
And
sorry.
They still asked me to do test trips. Ah, no, I'm good.
Okay.
I just did a line of coke.
What's a test? Oh, okay.
they give me clips and they're like, let's see what you can do. I'm like, I have a demo reel.
Yeah.
I've got two Emmys. You can look at all the shows I've
You're
worked
like,
on.
You're like, so it's basically.
So what can you do?
They're asking you to fill out an application when you have like an extensive resume and you're like, look, I'll do it, but look what I have here with me. Mm-hmm. I mean, right? Yeah. And does that ever get your foot in the door or are they still like, nah, just do the test clip, man?
From what I've seen is usually it's a sign that they're full of shit. You know, they want me to make a promo for their show.
Yeah.
And they're not really going to pay me for it. They just want a free promo. And they're basically using a lot of editors to create all these free promos so they don't actually have to pay editors to do it.
So do they, so sorry to interrupt, but do they, so then they probably have you sign something that says whatever you do for them, they can use. Yeah. Yeah, right?
No, they just say, let's see what you can do.
And then they don't even compensate you?
No, but I've gotten a little wiser. I put what's called a watermark on it. So it's got my name slapped across the middle of the video just so you can see it, but they can never use it.
That's
and
pretty
the
cool.
The last person I did to didn't even respond to me. I'm like, I spent hours working on this video and he's,
jerk.
Now, you got an interview for LFP at some point, right? Is that still in the works or is that something you've moved past?
They're going to contact me, I guess, after next week. I mean, they're interviewing one more person. Then next week they're going to take off for the holiday. And I'm hoping the week after that I'll find out.
Okay, cool. Well, good luck with that. Well, thanks for going into that, man. I hate to, you know, ask you a bunch of questions in an odd manner, but I felt it was important to try and get to the bottom of the Emmy thing, you know? I was just very curious. So thanks for doing comedy in Albuquerque, too. What do you think of the local scene, man?
I think it's great. I mean, I've done it in Los Angeles and Las Vegas, and I feel like the community is smaller but a lot better on average than those other two places. Mm. I mean, I've been more intimidated by the comedians out here because it's just a higher level of quality from the comedians.
Oh, okay.
There's very few comedians out here where I'm like, this guy shouldn't be doing comedy.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Even Greg, I find him amusing sometimes.
Wow. Yeah. He's
which is weird because every time you, like, when you're walking off stage, I'm always like, hey, good job, John. You should stop doing comedy.
you keep asking me what my day job is.
Yeah. I'm like, can you get more invested in that? Like, could you, like it more? Or?
That's funny.
All right, so we do have some videos to get to. Speaking of video, so there's the branding. I don't know. There was some question as to whether or not this was real or fake. I think it's real, but I'll let you guys decide. We saw the first half of this video a couple weeks ago, I think, and then this is the second half. You guys ever get together and do crazy stuff with your marketing friends? No.
Not everybody does, but recent.
No, but how about just crazy drunken shenanigans? When's the last time you made a crazy drunken decision about something to do? And incidentally, do you think this guy is drunk?
He has to be.
You think so?
His shirt is still on, so it's hard to tell, and he knew to put the gloves on.
There was a torch right next to his arm.
Yeah, so here we have these guys. It looks like some bros. Mm-hmm. And they...
No. It's real.
There's a lot of smoke.
It's real.
They brand him with a huge M. I don't know what that's for.
Yeah, where's the M mean?
Melissa, there we go. He's a huge fan. Who wouldn't be?
Yeah. What if it was really a W and they just accidentally got it
wrong? It's upside down. It's upside down, man.
Oh, no. I don't like it.
Have you guys ever been burned severely?
Yeah, when you did the crickets after I told a joke last time I was here.
Oh, that was a sick burn.
That was a sick burn.
Were those his friends? I mean, is that what friends do?
I think they wanted some information, and they were some friends.
Yeah.
You guys ever been burned really bad?
I have. Other than one time, I did not realize where the iron was while I was ironing. You know, kind of caught something on the arm. But other than that, no, I've never really been burned.
Did they call you Iron Man?
See, it didn't go to that level. Where's the crickets? You don't have the crickets.
Oh, there we go. There we go. There we go. Oh,
can you put that back when you edit this in post?
Yeah,
he will. He will.
Up until the iron story, I thought you were like really cool.
Well, this was as a child.
He's like, he never used iron.
It's a child move. I was a kid, so.
You guys have pets? Anybody here have a dog?
Oh, I've got a dog.
Yeah, but you do have a dog.
His You're name right is here, my dog.
Oh, hey.
Hey,
What about your pet, though?
Oh, yeah, I got
his
a dog.
His name's Arthur, right?
His name's Arthur. My girlfriend and I have recently been calling him my baby son.
Your baby son.
Instead of calling him Arthur, and it's because he's a small dog, and he gets excited about everything.
He sure
and,
does.
And it's like an ongoing bit we have where we refer to him as my son, and we were like, going to get lunch, and I said something about how, or my girlfriend was telling me that he likes her more, and I was like, well, I gave birth to him. He's my baby.
Would you ever take your dog to an airport?
No, he gets too crazy around people.
Overstimulated?
Yeah, he would get stressed out.
Well, people are taking their dogs everywhere, and we have a video. This went kind of viral last week. A lady took her dog to an airport, and seems like the dog was pretty well behaved.
Her dog just shit out all over the carpet. So.
So this, yeah, there's a lot more people flying that shouldn't be flying, and also they bring their dogs. Although this lady, it seems like she just is this white privilege. I can't decide.
I don't think so. I think she's waiting to clean it up. I always think well for people.
No.
Oh, no.
Not after that. Do you think a lady who flips off the camera would go back and...
clean up her dog shit? No.
That's maybe a pretty not. Impressive move that she actually flipped the bird while holding the phone.
Yeah, she did the move.
She shouldered it, right?
Yeah, she shouldered to throw the finger up, hold the dog. That woman's talented except for picking up dog shit.
Yeah, so I don't know. This lady was holding her poodle in Walmart today when I was getting something from the deli. And her poodle was cute, but I was like, do you really need that fucking dog in Walmart? Mm. Like, really, do you really?
Put him in your car.
Put him in your hot car and roll the windows up so no one steals them. Jesus.
Yeah. And he barks if the window's up. It's not so bad.
There's this other video that I came across where this dude gets knocked the fuck out. And then things get worse from there. I mean, being knocked out is pretty brutal.
Right.
But it seems like if there are certain areas of certain cities where if you get knocked out instead of getting help,
right,
you might get the opposite of help.
Okay.
So this gentleman, and I don't know what he did. He's kind of tatted up, and he's walking around in a neighborhood that it seems like people might know him in. So maybe he's getting his comeuppance.
I don't know. Okay.
Or maybe he's just a random victim of crime here. It's hard to tell. I don't know the whole story, but they're looking for the suspects, and it's some pretty good video. Cam, do you know which one I'm talking about?
Is it at the McDonald's?
No. That's not. I thought the McDonald's one was the Hammer one. The one that I sent you, the one that I'm talking about, is actually the... Where is it here?
That is pretty cool how you guys do this thing with the videos and whatnot.
Let's see here. Greg,
could you look at this thing that I have on my...
Yeah, that's fine. As long as it's not bleeding, I'll look at it.
It's a little pussy.
Okay. Hey.
There's one, buddy.
I have a question.
That relates to the first video we watched earlier with the little pussy.
By the way, pussy is not a word. It's pus-filled. Just want to let you know, because every time one of our medical receptionists sends a message to the doctor that says... This lady, her finger is very pussy.
She's got a little pussy situation.
Yeah.
It's technically not pus-filled if the pus is coming out, which makes it pussy.
Yeah, but I've had a lot of pussy in my day.
How much pussy have you had in your
situations
day?
Where I never felt like any pussy? Well, I would not have much pussy stuff. If it was pus filled, if that makes any sense. I'm not around any pus filled pussy. Alright. This video.
Samantha's gotten a lot of pussy.
Do you ever eat the pussy stuff?
What a pussy hound.
There's been pussy in my mouth. Abscess, it was called.
So here's a video that I was talking about here. You'll see the salt.
Oh,
boom.
Got him good.
Guy goes down. Oh yeah, he is knocked the fuck out. So here we go. Here's the assault.
Boop.
Sucker punch, dude.
Now, it looks like he may have known these guys. Maybe they asked him for something, but then things get worse. Then the neighborhood comes around to just see what they can get off this guy.
Right.
So maybe he was the neighborhood Debo or something like that, and people were like, he deserves to be robbed, but maybe he was just some dude who got knocked the fucked out, and then people came and stole his shit. So you see like three or four people going through his pockets.
Yeah. Well, how much stuff does he have in his pockets?
I don't know. Does he have cargo pants?
That's the guy who hit him. I know him from the shoes. That's the same guy who punched him earlier.
So now he's coming back and he's like, shit, this dude's still knocked out.
Let me call the cops, make sure he's okay. Yeah. It looks like he's calling the ambulance.
Yeah, there's a guy sleeping over
here. Actually, that's why this story.
I thought he was taking a picture.
That's why the story made news, because he took a picture of the dude and I think he posted it on his social media.
I was like, yo, I punched this guy.
But yeah,
or
so,
I saw someone punch this guy.
Someone punched this guy.
There he is, all happy.
Oh,
probably talking shit.
Oh yeah,
there's the cargo.
Look, here's
pants.
The high five. Look.
Oh.
He's all knocked him the fuck out. Bam! Let's go have a Miller.
Congratulations, we're so cool.
A Miller.
Let's have a Miller. I know specifically
Miller time.
Let's go. That was tough.
And then that kind of leads us into, Cam, let's go to that McDonald's video that we were talking about. Is this the Hammer one? Please, Hammer, don't hurt him.
I thought the McDonald's video was the guy with the M getting burnt into his chest.
Oh, that.
Hey. That is actually how you get it to the higher levels of McDonald's.
That's M for manager.
Yeah, he was getting assistant manager.
Mm-hmm. McDonald's McManagement.
Are you sure it wasn't Wendy's?
Oh, yeah, that's right. It was upside
back
down.
Back to the W.
We're partying too hard, dude.
Okay, so here is the McDonald's fight. When did this happen, Cam? Do you know?
Oh, nice.
Oh, this is in West Hollywood.
Oops, it probably happened at least maybe a month ago.
I was going to say, how did you recognize that McDonald's?
I read it at the time. Oh, no, they're specific in West Hollywood.
I never tell you, boo-boo.
The West Hollywood
I think I've been to that one.
Have you?
Yeah, I lived in West Hollywood.
Okay, so let's see here.
Is that the one by the Arc Light?
Oh, yeah, I've been to this one, too. Yeah, it's right by the Arc Light. Yeah.
Oh, dude, I straight up, rubbed down at this one before. I had, $5 in my bank account.
Get him.
Oh, shit.
Win, McDonald's, win.
Oh, shit. Damn.
They have to. So wait, the McDonald's employees are fighting some dude with, what does he have, a bike?
He has a bicycle.
Oh, shit. What the fuck?
Get him, McManager.
Oh, shit. And they're, like, throwing shit back and forth over the counter.
I know. What does he have in his hand? I want to know. A roll of newspaper? Bad customer.
Don't do it again.
Bad customer. I bet it was over sauce.
I was about to say, this is why you give the guy two barbecue sauces, not just one.
Well, it's 25 cents for extra sauce, sir.
Yeah, but he didn't have it, clearly.
He brought his bicycle in. He can't even lock it up.
Mm-hmm. Hey, why is this so well done?
Yeah, it's like they had a cinematographer.
Yeah.
I'm always suspicious when there's credits at the end of it. Or they have different
it's like
cuts.
News cuts or something.
Yeah. Oh, okay, that makes sense. Because I'm like, this is awesome. This is the best production of a fight I've ever seen.
Oh, and why would it?
Do you think somebody used this as part of their demo reel? For they're an actor and they're like, I need to get this on my demo reel.
The McDonald's continued to serve customers after the confrontation.
There was ketchup and barbecue sauce everywhere.
Still no sign of Szechuan sauce. And they need to change that trash, by the way. Instead of fighting your customers, why don't you go change the that's probably why he was mad. Like, I can't put my trash in the trash can.
And he came in. Because
it's getting on my nerves. Come change this trash. And
they're like, get your bicycle out of here.
I ain't moving my bicycle to y'all. Change that trash can.
I just got this damn M branded on my chest. It hurts.
I'm the assistant manager of this place, goddammit.
I'm Mick Management, bro.
Jesus Christ, why is this going so long? What is up with this video?
It's somebody's real demo reel of the news.
Like 3-4 minutes of it.
Someone trying to get an editing job.
So much better for them.
I know, Smilowitz. Jeez, get you on the case. All right, real quick, let's. You know what? I know we've seen this video before, but I want to close out our video section with. Can we look at the monkey video again?
Oh, I'm down for
that. That one is so fucking cool. Have you guys seen that one?
Is that
the monkey Coco? Video?
Hey,
with the monkey.
Oh, yeah. Close. Yeah. So let's see here.
The new monkeys track.
Yeah, Davy Jones. Very big with the kids.
Oh,
because you said the monkeys, you know.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, he's dead.
Okay.
No. I recently, thank you, Jones.
His body is dead.
His body is dead. His spirit lives on, though.
Yeah.
Okay, so, yeah, let's, you know which one I'm talking about, Cam, right?
Oh, yeah.
There's a lot of content in the chat, right?
Red tape to get around.
Wow. You want to press a button?
Wait, can I press a button?
Press a button. Nope. James Brown.
That's what that was?
He doesn't love James Brown, yeah.
I love James Brown. I didn't know that was
a bad
word. It's like a whole story.
Okay, here we go.
Okay.
Oh, I did see this.
No way.
I saw this video.
He watched that.
And then he left.
Bro, he munches off. He pushes it back.
He's like, I'm done, bro.
Hey, my nigga.
Is he still
on? Hey, you good?
He's offering a blood.
He really is hot.
He is fucked up.
I have so many questions.
I have so many answers.
Was he wearing the Canadian shirt before he got stoned?
I know that they put that on because he was stoned. Was he cold now? Like, what does the fur do when you were high?
Yeah.
Does it just not work anymore? But his face at the end looked like
it was a stone monkey,
right?
Low
as fuck, and I've had the time of my life. I know a lot of people look at that as probably cruelty to animals. We need to ask the monkey first.
Yeah, we should. Ask
that guy looked like he had
like
the time of his
good.
Life.
Yeah, right.
Teach the guy sign language, and then ask him and sign.
One of the comments was, "I don't know if this is animal abuse, but that monkey can take a dab."
That's right.
Fucking true. Yeah.
Like, why did he did all the work? Like,
he knew. He's taken dabs before.
Taking dabs is not something that you do involuntarily.
Right. I've never heard of anyone who was like, "Oh, and then I just started taking dabs. It's crazy."
Well, they should have passed it around, and if it got back to him and he just naturally knew what to do,
yeah.
Obviously it's not cruelty.
It's not cruelty, no. Oh, we're getting towards the end of the show. We're getting into three-question territory.
Okay.
So we have three questions here. Questions for our guests, that is. Let's go ahead and start with Jay. Jay, let's see here. Question number one of three questions for you. Who do you think will make love to our president first, Melania, Putin, or Kim Jong-un?
Kim Jong-un.
Kim Jong-un. Good answer. Good answer. Greg?
I think he'll kiss Kim Jong-un first, but he'll get down and fuck Putin.
Oh, yeah.
Way before. Because I feel like Kim Jong-un is going to take some time, take it slow. Putin's just down to fuck.
He's just down to
fuck. He's like, I don't even want to kiss you, dude. Like, I just want to fuck you.
Putin's like
that's
a,
how it goes.
Putin's like a power top, right? He just fucks hard. He's like face down, ass up type of guy, right?
Yeah, and then it turns out Donald Trump's like a real femme bottom.
Yeah. He's always
overcompensating in public.
So. He's all about control, so I think he's going to be a sub in the bedroom is what I'm going to say. Yeah, sense, for yeah. sure. Melissa, who's going to make love to our president first, Melania, Putin, or Kim Jong-un?
Go with Putin.
So nobody's going to say Putin. His wife.
Yeah, no. All right.
She's probably going to say Ivanka.
So.
But.
question number two. Three questions here. Let's go to John Smilowitz.
You got to press it every time.
Oh, every time? Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Three questions. Question number two. We'll start with John Smilowitz. John, what should ICE do with all those babies? Now, ICE has taken away a bunch of Mexican babies, separating them from the families, major protests this weekend. The nation was up in arms about this. John Smilowitz, what's your plan for these babies that ICE has taken, robbed from their parents?
Oh, I figured this one out last night. I posted the answer.
What's the answer?
I say you keep the families together. Once they cross the American border, put the families on a bus, drive them up to the Canadian border, and say, have a nice day, eh?
And just get them across
Canada
the border.
And I think deal that's with good. Them.
They got, like, we got weed-smoking monkeys over here. This is a cool-ass city. City. Country. I don't know what's going on anymore. Where am I? Who are you?
Mexico let them all the way through Mexico, and they're like, okay, America, there are problems.
Just give them an olé to Canada, right?
Yeah.
Is that what you want to do? Not a bad idea.
Problem solved.
Jay, what should we do with all these babies ICE has?
We should hire them for Super Bowl halftime shows for the next 24 years. I'm down for that.
There's enough money in that.
It's forgivable for me once that happens. But that has to happen. 24 straight Super Bowls, ICE children. They should be called the ICE children.
Are they going to play football?
I don't know what they're going to do. I didn't even think that far.
They're hired by the Super Bowl.
Because to me... Everybody gonna say good for them. I think when I watch the Super Bowl and I see the halftime show and I see these children that we know from these cages and all this kind of stuff in the metal blankets, I mean the foil blankets, and I look at that and once I see the Super Bowl halftime show, I'm like, good for them. Yeah, thank you for
that. We have to say ice babies.
Ice babies.
Now, why do they have them in foil blankets? Is that just like a sanitary thing? Like they're easier to wash, or are they like, hey?
I think it was God. And the only reason I think it was God because I went to a lot of open mics where these open mic comedians said, they got them wrapped like burritos. I mean, so many people said they got them wrapped like burritos. I was all like, God must have wanted these guys to do these jokes so I didn't respect their comedy anymore. That was what it was.
Yeah, you're like, yeah. They needed to identify all the hacks in the LA scene. You're like, here we go. Here's the way God's like, okay, listen, I know it's like hundreds of thousands of little babies, but like, I gotta get the hacks out of LA.
We'll work with
those. I'm tired of this shit.
We're gonna get them in Super Bowls.
Yeah, we're gonna get them in Super Bowls. It's gonna be fine, little kids. It's gonna be fine.
I gotta separate them.
And the,
okay.
That's the wrong
Sorry. Guy. I thought we had a good riff, Jay.
There we go. Let's see here. Okay, last question, three questions. We'll go to Melissa Esslinger off camera. Melissa, question number three questions. Undertaker or Mankind? Now, this question can be taken however you want. Undertaker or Mankind? It could be a would ya. It could be who's better. It could be who's bigger. Whatever you want. Undertaker or Mankind?
Ooh, that's a tough one.
That is a tough
one. I don't know.
The Undertaker had some balls to still stay in character during every time he owned the... It was Mankind that was dying, right?
Every time he killed him, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, every time he killed him, he still... I don't know. I don't know how I feel about that, but it's notable.
Melissa says Undertaker, probably.
It seems like.
He does sleep in a coffin, you know. So.
It makes sense then, actually.
John Smilowitz, Undertaker or Mankind?
Definitely Undertaker.
Okay. And Jay, Undertaker or Mankind?
Mankind, unless Paul Bearer is with Undertaker, then...
Rest in peace, Paul Bearer.
Because if he can talk like that all the time... But if you give me a Paul Bearer Mankind combo, then I'm rolling with that. Because Mick Foley, you don't know what you're going to get from this guy.
Now, do you remember when Paul Bearer died... And they actually brought it as a storyline into the WWE.
Right.
And Undertaker was like, they had like, they were saying it was Paul Bearer's urn. It was pretty crazy.
Yeah, I remember that. I remember that.
A few years ago. Greg, Undertaker or Mankind?
Well, you know, John mentioned that Undertaker sleeps in his coffin. And I feel like that's like shitting where you eat. And I don't respect that. So I'm going to have to go deal with Mankind. And when you think about it, Mankind always wins.
Very true.
Me too moment. Really? Not.
It never needs to die.
You've seen the movie Armageddon.
I feel like Barbecue Betty.
And you saw Independence Day 2?
Actually, I didn't. Thank God.
I haven't either, but I know how it ends because it's basically the same movie as what I've heard. And I'll go by that. All right.
Perfect timing, everybody. That's the show. Time for Plugola. We know that Greg has a show coming up. Tell us about that show again and anything.
Yeah, so at tonight's show, 10 p.m., headliner Jay Green coming in from L.A. Nice. We also got featuring forum Kurt Fletcher. We got Melissa Esslinger. Woo! And then the hosts of the show are going to be on the show, too. It's Ajayo Daniels and Maverick McWilliams. It's going to be at their house, so I'm not going to give their address on here, but find me on Instagram or Twitter, Instagram /slow_virus. Instagram is @all_tired. Twitter is is /slow_virus. Or find me on Facebook, Greg's Comedy Friendship. I'll send you the info. Come out to the show. It's $3. It's going to be a lot of fun.
Nice.
I said it fast enough.
What else do you have coming up? Anything else past that?
I'm doing a show with Patrick Hasty and Matt Ziamak, which is actually his real name. It's almost like mine, but with a couple vowel changes. He's from Tucson. Patrick's from New York. They're coming through late July doing Bozy Brothers.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, awesome. It's going to be fun.
Brothers, check that out. Mm-hmm. John Smilowitz, where do you want people to see your stuff? Where do you want people to look at?
I actually have absolutely nothing to promote. I have no shows. I only do open mics now.
Well,
although
four now.
I am looking for somebody who can show me how to create a videotape so I can go and get booked for real shows.
Booked
if somebody could help me get a manager, I will do things.
Well, have you taped any of your sets? You basically, you need to get on a show, right, so you can like tape a set and then you can have like a clip you can send out and stuff like that. It's basically...
I hate watching myself, so I don't like taping sets. I'm horrible.
Really?
Yeah, I hate not very funny.
You have to walk through that fire, you know, at some point to look at to get your clips down and stuff like that.
Okay, I'll try that.
All right, do that. Well, maybe we'll see you at the open mics this week then, huh? Okay, cool, man.
Except for Greg's.
It's the best open mic in town.
Second.
Right after his mic.
It's pretty good.
It's no robot. Laser kid.
Hey, listen, it's the only open mic where both of the hosts will yell at the entire audience.
Very true.
For the first 10 minutes of the show while trying to teach the audience about something that makes no sense.
Eric Manea. Hey, I learned about...
We got sexy Latinas, we got skeleton gifts, we got all the good shit on our open mic. Okay, John?
I did learn about Italy last week.
Yeah, so. You learned a lot about Italy. Okay, Paisan?
Paisan.
And bring your Emmys next time, too.
Yeah, bring both of them next time. And maybe things will go better.
Jay, you got the gig coming up tonight.
So we know
the
about Greg's tonight. Apparently, there's 60 Latinas gonna be here.
No, it's at my open mic. Well, I mean, I could talk to the sexy
I wasn't
Latinas.
Sure if those were the same.
Listen,
when I was
we'll
excited.
Talk. We'll talk to the sexy Latinas.
Because this is a New Mexico. Like, there's a Mexico and then there's a New Mexico. Anyway, I can be found on social media at J Green LOL. That's the letter J, the color green, and LOL like laugh out loud. But I do a podcast called the Fresh Jays Podcast in Los Angeles. We have a Fresh Jays comedy show. It's at the Zen Lounge in LA. If ever you're out, come check us out. The Zen Lounge, the next show will be on the 11th of July. So
tell a little bit about your podcast. What do you guys do on that?
So my podcast, we basically cover the hot topics in hip-hop and sports. Like, so a lot of the stuff that's going on. And then a lot of times if there's something going on in Black Twitter, we'll cover that, what's happening in that. So we've been doing them for about a year and a half. They're fun and they're random. Sometimes we do a live show after our Fresh Jays comedy show. So we do our regular podcast, and then even when we do the Fresh Jays comedy show, we'll have a live show where anybody who was on the show can just hop on and we just goof off. And
nice.
We're usually almost drunk by that point.
Real quick, you do sports stories. Where is LeBron going? I say LA is Los the most Angeles. Likely destination.
He's going to LA. I just can't see him going anywhere else because nothing else gives him the opportunity to be
that big.
So, like, part of me as a Laker fan doesn't like LeBron because I'm like, we're better than him. We don't need him. But as soon as they said he's coming, I'm like, okay, come on, throw.
So. Well, and I think it's pretty cool. One of the big things he's talked about is he wants to play with his son.
Yeah.
Like, that would be so fucking cool. That's never happened in the NBA.
Not in the NBA, for him
to be so good that he can play into his late 30s, early 40s.
Right.
But then his son to be so fucking good that he can come along and play when he's 18 or 19. Holy fuck.
That would be genius. That'd be
fucking cool, right?
I'm excited about that because they'll be on the Lakers.
Yeah, that would be great. And from what I hear, sorry to go into this, but I hear that a lot of it is hinging on Kawhi Leonard, but it doesn't look like Kawhi Leonard's going there. It looks like he might go to Boston or something.
Yeah, it requires a trade. And we don't know if we need a trade because we have so many nice young players. It doesn't make sense to get rid of them just to get this guy.
Yeah, San Antonio's like, hey, we want this, and this. Keep Lonzo Ball, though.
No, you can have that. But everything else, run that. Well, they don't want the dad. They don't want LeVar.
Right on. So check out that podcast. Yes, check him out tonight. That would be great. Melissa, want to step over to the mic and give us some plugola here? Yeah.
Well, because I've got a birthday show coming.
Ooh,
well,
birthday show.
It's not until the end of August. But I'm taping it. I'm hiring like a camera crew and shit.
Cool.
It's gonna be at the Guild, August 24th, 10:30. It's a Friday night.
Nice.
I want to fill that place.
Very cool. Yeah.
Yeah, it's gonna be fun.
How much are tickets?
They're $7.
Okay.
Yep, $7, and I'm gonna release a T-shirt that I've been working on for a little while. It's Fly Like a Bunny, which is adorable.
Oh,
do you need an editor? I'll do a test clip for you.
Yeah, you can do a test clip of the whole show.
All right.
I'm just kidding.
And then you have the gig tonight.
Yeah, I got the Greg show tonight. I'm excited. That'll be good.
Cool. Are you coming out to any of the mics or doing any shows before your August stuff?
I don't have. Well, I've got First Friday next next week already.
Oh, nice. Those are fun.
I've placed every time, but I didn't do last month's because at work. Marking too much.
No,
I haven't been doing as many mics because of that either. But
are you still doing PA?
Work? Yeah, and we're like in the right smack in the middle of it right now. So
very busy.
Right? Very busy. They own me.
Well, make sure you check her out when you can this weekend and then in August. Yeah. And Cam Commander Anderson, you have anything to promote? Anything you want people to know about?
Nothing really. Just check out Voice Box Studios. We got a bunch of podcasts there, too, along with Talk That Loud and hopefully Grasping That Void and stuff, too. So.
Oh, yeah. Talk That Loud, the podcast you do with your lovely girlfriend. You guys talk about all kinds of stuff. Watch
and
current
their brother.
Videos, all that kind of stuff.
We just watch viral videos. Same shit.
Cool.
Yeah, do, essentially.
Cool. I am John Cuellar, of course. Condolences to Alan Clark's family for his highway death or trip to Colorado, whichever it is.
If the Allen family could bring his diapers to me, I could use them. I'm running low.